Spike told me what Brecken and his team have been working on. A night run. He must be desperate. We all are, I guess. It's in the best interest of me and my mission to set up an escape route for Brecken's team and arm traps for...
Hey, keep a distance from... This man, they just... Keep a lookout for the colored smoke. It means air drop.
I'm outside, working for Spike.
You're Crane, right? Listen, our runner's trying to secure one of our safe houses for Brecken's mission. He's in a courtyard by Vefa and Mimar, surrounded by zombies. We gotta help him.
All right, I'm on it.
Yeah.
Okay, Jade, I'm here, along with some infected.
Watch yourself, Crane.
Ah, shit.
How's it coming? Got the light?
Almost. Just give me a second. Here.
Report.
Okay, I met this doctor, scientist type. They've got him set up in a sort of research trailer, and he's working on a cure for the virus. His name is Zara. Hello? Do you copy?
Affirmative. Secondary objective added. Maintain your cover and secure all of his research. Acknowledge.
Your stolen file still takes top priority, though, right?
Affirmative. We find it unlikely that a single researcher working out of a trailer could produce any significant results. But if he does, we want to see it.
Jade, it's done.
Good. We'll need to prepare more places like that one. We've got more spots picked out for future safe zones. Spike will mark them on your map later. And Crane, thank you. Back to you, Spike.
Right now, you need to get back to our main task and arm the next.
Got it. The infected are all over the street.
So what does that tell you? Keep off the street. Try to stay on the rooftops where they can't reach you.
Well, they're all around the car, Spike.
You still have some firecrackers, don't you? Just throw some into the crowd. Those dead bastards are easily distracted.
Thank you. All done with the car, Spike.
Keep on like that, you just might make it. Next truck's still spotted. I shouldn't have to tell you, but don't get caught out in the open.
Spike, these freaks are everywhere. If I need to use a trap, how do I activate it?
You can't. I told you, they're only for the night mission.
Shit. Okay. What a contraption you got here.
Three times brighter than an ordinary street lamp. Gives the infected quite the sunburn.
Thank you.
Lights are all set.
You ready for the next one, then? Better hurry.
Fuck, Spike, the whole goddamn district went down. What the hell's going on?
Not again. All right, listen. There's a power substation near you. Go check it out. Hey, this blackout has really put us in a tight spot. We're defenseless here. Most of the safe zones and some of my traps are down, too. We need to get the power up and running ASAP.
I've got the substation reset, but if the grid shorted once, you know it could happen again, right?
You leave leave the electrical engineering to me, okay? Just get your ass to a safe zone. You're gonna have to spend the night there.
I saw this freaking weird zombie. He's covered in big green blisters. It hauled ass as soon as it spotted me. You know anything about it?
Not enough information, I'm afraid. But if you see another one, do let me know.
Something bad happened. We need to talk.
Okay, give me a sec.
Thank you. Crane. First of all, you did great out there. From now on, if you need something, come see me. And to start with, use a UV flashlight and a remote control. You run up on a volatile, give him a face full of UV, or lead him into a trap which you can trigger with that remote. You got it?
Got it.
Perfect. Now for the bad news. Despite your efforts, Brecken's mission failed.
Shit, is he okay?
He's alive. But you need to get back to the tower. Jay called all the scouts in, and that means you.
Crane here.
Report.
I'm about to have a meeting with the tower's leader.
Acknowledged. Confirm his identity and contact us immediately.
I feel like there's nothing outside. Things are bad. Very bad.
Brecken's mission failed. Jade called a meeting in the tower. It's my opportunity to finally meet with.
Good job out there, 31. Crane, right?
Crane. Listen, Brecken and a team of runners went after an airdrop last night. He lost the rest of his team to biters, and then Ryze's men ambushed him, beat him to a pulp, and stole the drop. Now Brecken wants to go after the next drop himself, but we can't let him, and you've got to back me up, okay?
For God's sake! You can't even walk straight! We need you alive, you idiot!
Okay, we're going in. Act confident. Brecken? Lena?
Maybe you can get through to him.
Jade, who's your friend?
Kyle Crane.
Look, Brecken, the last thing we need is for you to go back out there. We can figure out another way without jeopardizing you. Right, Crane?
I'll go. I'll do it.
Right. Yes. Crane will go. He'll be happy to.
Jesus. No offense, friend, but you're as green as grass. You can't just...
Crane will manage. He'll start in the right spot. And Lena's right. You need to be here taking care of the towers, convincing them the world's not over yet.
Oh, hell. Maybe one more try before we go to Ryze. Yeah. Okay, fine. Good luck, Crane. Jade, a moment.
Sure. Head for the cauldron. I'll be in touch shortly.
Look, there's something else we need to discuss. Brecken was hurt pretty bad out there. Worse than he wants people to know. He took a blow to the head. Now he's starting to have seizures, and I don't have any Loratrax.
Yeah, I doubt anyone does. Anti-seizure drugs were being passed out like candy when the infection first started. And the stores ran out weeks ago.
Yes, that's right. How do you know that?
Look, what do you need me to do, Lena?
There's a man in town named Ghazi. He's not altogether there, if you know what I mean. His mother had epilepsy, so he used to pick up medicine for her each month. She died 2 years ago. But Ghazi kept going to the store to pick up her prescription. He likes his routine, and Ghazi can be very insistent. So, they kept giving it to him.
Think he's been stockpiling it all this time?
If he hasn't, I don't know where else we're going to get it from. Ghazi lives under the overpass. And don't mention his mother's death. He won't understand.
Dawood must still have a lot of things in that pawn shop of his. Yeah, probably a bit of everything, really. I sure could use some of that stuff now.
Hey, do you have spare keys for 202?
What's the problem?
Something's going on in there. The door's locked from inside.
Is that you?
Look, I've got to get out of here. I need to get my wife and kids somewhere safe.
You know, it seems to me this is about the only safe place there is.
Safest place in the slums, maybe, but the slums aren't safe. It's no place for my family. And I found a way out.
You mean out of the slums?
I can't tell you the details, but I need to get across town, and I can't do it without a gun. If you'll get me one, I'll tell you about a place that hasn't been looted yet. I promise you won't regret it.
Well, how do you know this place hasn't been looted?
Because there's only one person that has access to this place, and you're looking at him. Bring me a gun, and the key is yours, as well as everything you find there.
Hey, could you check on Bahir in 202 and see if he's around? Tell him he's late for his shift and Seth is getting mad. Could you do that for me?
Sure, if I see him. What's going on here?
Bayer's locked himself in the room. We could hear him screaming.
He may have turned.
You hear that?
I can't get this lock. You want to try it?
Give it a try.
Oh, he's good.
Bahir, you in here?
Help me.
Tell me what's wrong.
I can't move. My chest feels like it's going to explode.
Are you turning?
No, no. I took Antizin and the pain started. The vial is on the floor.
What you took is junk.
What?
It's fake. Where did you get this from, Bahir?
Please, I need a doctor.
First, tell me who sold you that.
I can't, I promised. This guy is very useful. He brings me things from the outside.
Yeah, like phony Antizin? People could be giving this to their kids. You want them to go through this?
No! God, no!
Then tell me who sold it to you.
Yusuf. He's one of the scouts. He lives on the roof.
Okay, I'll get Dr. Lena.
Oh, please, hurry!
What happened?
Did you kill him?
What? No. Look, he's not turning, but he needs a doctor.
I thought he was turning.
We should still keep an eye on him.
You better have a look at this.
The lot number's wrong. Is this a fake?
Someone on 21 took it, and now he can't even get off the floor.
Aman, get down to 21 now. Where did he get it from?
Yusuf. He's one of the scouts.
Well, he can't be producing it here. Someone's supplying him.
I'll have a talk with Yusuf.
The sooner the better. Don't hurt him. Just talk to him.
You should watch your step.
Yusuf?
Welcome to Yusuf's Emporium. If it's hard to find, you need to find Yusuf. Whatever your needs, Yusuf has it all.
Yeah, I'm looking for Antizin.
Well, of course you are. My friend, this is your most lucky day.
No, Yusuf, it's your lucky day. Because I'm going to give you a chance to come clean and tell me where you got that counterfeit junk you sold to Bahir.
Bahir? Bahir, you say? Do I know this, Bahir?
He nearly died from that phony Antizin you sold him.
Phony? Are you sure? You're saying it's no good. I just bought 10 vials from those guys. I paid good money.
Which guys?
Well, that's kind of a sensitive issue.
Which guys, Yusuf? I'm running out of patience.
There's a building next to the drugstore. A couple of survivors live there. I don't know how many. I've never been inside. They have medicines. Some of them are real. I guess from the drugstore. They also cook their own stuff. The guy I deal with is named Bento.
All right, now you're going to burn the rest of those vials.
But they cost me a lot of money.
It'll cost you a lot more if I find you peddling that junk anymore.
Crane, it's Lena.
Go ahead.
We found two more vials of that fake antidote. Reckon it's boiling now.
Yeah, I bet. How's Bahir?
He's stable. But if we go to him 10 minutes later, he wouldn't be. This stuff is lethal, Crane. Putting them out of business is your number one priority.
Alright, understood. with you.
Get that bastard!
So?
So what can I do for you, my friend? Yeah, I hear you're selling Antizen.
Who told you that? A little bird?
Not just the same person who told me you've been cooking up garbage and putting it in fake vials?
Garbage? My formula is 50 times better than that crap they drop in boxes. Not only does it keep you healthy, it gives you super strength, incredible speed, and laser eyes. I could burn you with one look if I wanted to.
I'm shutting you down, Bento.
Yeah. Yusuf said you'd try to make trouble.
Yeah, well, Yusuf was right.
And you're fucking dead!
We've got a visitor.
You can't get us all!
Cheating?
Use your power! What is this shit? I'm not done with you. You motherfucker! You can get to pieces! This is it for you!
Lena, it's Crane.
Yes.
You can tell Brecken that counterfeit lab's out of business.
Good work, Crane. That's a big relief. Are you all right?
I'm fine, but Yusuf tipped him off that I was coming.
I was afraid of that. Brecken was going to lock him up, but he'd already slipped out.
Now, if he comes back, I'm gonna have a word with him.
Not if Bahir gets to him first.
So much for helping me.
Ah!
Gazi? Is anybody in here? Gazi, are you there?
If Mama ain't happy, nobody happy. So you better make Mama happy.
Gazi?
Me too. We have the same name. Are you from the video store?
No, my name's Crane.
Crane? Crane rhymes with train and brain and sane and grain and rain and plane and the other kind of plane and...
But can I come in?
No, no. It's impossible. Impossible. This is my special day with Mom. It's Mother's Day, and it's the most important day of the whole world. Are you from the video store?
Why do you keep asking me that?
Because you're supposed to bring my movie about me. It's called Charlie. And it's all about me. And how smart I am.
Look, Gazi, if I bring you your movie, will you let me come in?
Sure. Then you could watch with us. It is Mother's Day. And if Mama ain't happy, nobody happy. Oh, and she also wants chocolate. Mama wants chocolate.
No, 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 wait a minute. That's too much.
Don't argue with Gazi. It doesn't work. That's what the drugstore people say.
Excuse me?
Would you look at me, friend, and think that man is a success? No? I do not blame you, but I am. You see, I was. Almost every gasoline station in Harran I owned. And when they announced the Global Athletics Games, it was supposed to be like a windfall. Like winning the lottery.
That didn't work out, huh?
Well, look around you. What do you think? Huh? Harran was a decent place to live. Maybe a little backward in some ways, but we got by. Then we won the bid for the games. All the promises they made us. Average citizens were supposed to become wealthy. And the wealthy, well, we were supposed to become kings. I am no king. All the dreams we had, the plans we made, gone in the blink of an eye. And it wasn't just successful entrepreneurs either. The government filled all our heads with golden promises. Are you a window washer? An appliance repairman? A ditch digger? The games will transform your lives. Your world will change. Yes, our world changed. Sure enough. You take a good look around you, friend. You take a good look and you tell yourself, I must appreciate what I have right now in this place. Because it can all be snatched away from you in the time it takes to blink your eyes.
Son of a bitch, not now. Gotcha. Here's your movie and your chocolates.
Wait till Mom see this. Oh, Gazi wins again. Hooray for Gazi!
Right. Yeah, then I'll just let myself in through the roof. Hello, Gazi.
Shh! The movie is hot. Mama's watching. Is Mama happy? Yeah, Mama's real happy. Gazi got her chocolates and a movie.
Well, then I'm gonna take some medicine to help my friend.
Well, okay. Oh, Mama stopped getting seizures when her head turned into a pumpkin. They're on the table.
Yeah, thanks, Gazi.
Gazi make everybody happy.
Thank you. Crane here.
Report.
Tower boss is named Brecken, and he's definitely not your man. The other likely suspect is this warlord, basically. Local guy. Calls himself Ryze. He's hoarding Antizin and then gouging the hell out of anybody who wants to buy some. I'm on a mission to get Antizin from the airdrop. If I don't succeed, they'll have to come up with something else.
Acknowledged. Good job, Crane. You're doing well. Stay on task, and we'll be in touch. Be sure to call us immediately if and when you get that Antizin.
Is out.
I've got your anti-seizure medicine.
Thanks. Oh, how'd things go with Gazi?
Well, he may be challenged, but he's very good at getting what he wants.
Did you meet his mom?
Yeah, she seemed happy.
If Mama ain't happy, ain't nobody happy. Speaking of which, Brecken asked me to pass this on to you, with his thanks. Good work taking out that Antizin lab. You've saved a lot of lives.
Now it's only a matter of time before someone starts another one.
The danger is all those empty Antizin bottles out there. People throw them away, and then anyone can refill them with whatever they like.
Now you better start destroying them.
We've collected all the bottles in the tower. Plus, Brecken is offering a $10 bounty for every bottle you runners find out there.
Thank you.